Hello YouTube, and welcome to another general vlog video. Tonight, we are doing a little soldering on a guitar. And I didn't know if maybe you guys wanted me to show you kind of how to solder, because I'm definitely not a professional. But let's try this and see what we come up with. Let's get you down here on the guitar itself. So let me try to get up in here, and it's going to be kind of hard to do and tricky to film and everything while I'm doing this. So let me get down here and grab my glasses, and I'll show you what we're trying to do. Is there is a repair right here. You can hear it staticky whenever I touch it. So what we're going to try to do is solder that little joint right there, the two wires together. And we got our solder, which is just a General Electric rosin core solder. And we got our soldering iron, and we're going to try to lay this under it to kind of try to heat up the wire. There we go. And I do believe, yes sir, we got her soldered. So let me go over here into the work bag. I thought I'd seen some black tape in here. Maybe not. Okay, let me get in some of my bins over here. All right, now we got some black tape. Now, the correct thing to do on this would have been to use heat shrink, but I know I have some, but I wasn't able to find it. And this is just this is a guitar that I've had for years. I had back when I was a kid. And it's really been abused, so to speak. So we're going to put that around it, because, you know, if you notice, if you touch certain things in here, then... So what I had to do is I had to rewater the white wire down to the lead on the tone. This is my kill switch. That was made famous by somebody like Eddie Van Halen or something like that, back before I really had much of a taste in music. Ha ha ha. So, I'm just generally looking. I had to resolder. If you look, let me get this so I can kind of point. I just resoldered this. This was going to my tailpiece, my tremolo system, and it kind of grounds the whole system out. So it looks like I'm checking all my connections. That connection there looks good. And that connection there looks good. That connection there looks good. Move that out of way just a little bit. That looks good. That looks good. There's the transformer there. Well, not transformer, but diode. And there's the switch. And it all looks good on the switch wiring. That looks good. That looks good. That's got a little bit of a... Let's take... just a little bit of black tape. I think I can see some wire through that. It looks like it's rubbed raw on something, or maybe I hit it with a soldering iron. So we'll put a little black tape around that. And all right, so hopefully I'm not blinding you guys with my light, but if you need to see down in there better, there's the cavity of it. So let's get this where I'm not blinding you guys. And let me grab a pickup here. We're already plugged in. Let's see. I know we're not going to be in tune, so this guitar has not been touched in years. So let's see. No, I'm not really trying to play anything. I'm just... Okay, so basically let me explain this little guitar to you real quick. This is something I wanted back when I was a kid. I added the stripes to it because that's what Eddie Van Halen did back then. Yeah, surprise, I used to listen to that kind of music. So basically, let me go ahead and get my tremolo bar out here. Back years and years and years ago, I rewired this. And by rewiring this, I didn't know what I was doing, to say the least. I didn't know what I was doing. So, I tore it all apart when I was young to try to make what I thought was going to be the sound that Eddie Van Halen's guitar got. Well, I basically unsoldered a bunch of wires and I didn't know what I was doing. So I never could figure out how they went back together. So basically, when I'm on my neck pickup or my bridge pickup, which is back here, and if you can see, you can hear if I hold the strings, so you don't hear anything like you do back here. But when I did that, then I ended up with no volume. But a swell sound. On my tone. Which, to me, I thought that was the coolest thing. Because I could kind of get that. I don't know if you can hear that. Now, along with that and my Jim Dunlop volume pedal, I could make these weird noises that I thought sounded like what Eddie Van Halen's did. That's wired wrong. Okay, so then we come up to the middle pickups, or the middle position, which is both pickups. And you can see, we have one of the humbuckers up here. That one there slightly works. These both back here work. And with that one, we got the same thing up here on the volume. It's a little scratchy. I'm going to try to fix that tonight. And then back here, we got the same thing. So I was able to use that in my volume pedal to come up with those sounds. Then you go up to what should be the neck pickup, and we have basically all of them working a little bit. Not great. And then this goes to a mostly volume. No tone, but that is the tone knob. And this in here is pretty much inoperable on that. So because of this, And then a kill switch, of course. Okay, so let me take my little nerdy glasses off here. Let me go ahead and cut that off. And let's get you up here. As you can see, I don't know how well you can see. There's many guitars behind me. They're everywhere in this room. One back in there, here. So basically, what had happened was, as a young person, I didn't know what I was doing. Eddie Van Halen had this thing called a Frankenstrat that was basically, excuse me, got something in my mouth. Basically, a look-alike Fender body with Gibson humbucker pickup in it, and completely changed the world of music, both rock and even country, blues, everything. It was all Frankenized, Frankenstratted, you know, it had part of a pick guard. Anyways, I wanted something similar to that. And back when I bought this, it was Charvel or Jackson was where you really wanted to be. And I didn't want this necessarily. I wanted a Jackson, or I wanted the Charvel with what we call the hockey stick headstock. But when you're young, you know, money's tight. So I got what I could. And then I striped it myself. I butchered the wiring and everything myself. Now, I can get right on here, if you'll look, on my phone, is a wiring diagram for that exact guitar. Well, I could wire it back to the way that it should be, but here's my thought. This is something I did and loved when I was a kid. So why would I change it now? I mean, yeah, now that I've learned, I could go back, I could do it correctly, but why? This is something, this is actually a classic for me. This is a throwback from when I didn't know what I was doing, but I was able to come up with sounds that were better to me than it being stock. Yes, I had to end up learning to use a volume pedal. Excuse me. I have a volume pedal over here. I have probably, well, let me go ahead and just kind of zoom you into this. See that right there? There? That volume pedal. I've had that volume pedal since I was a little kid. And I got it because of mistakes like this. You know, and I thought, wow, that volume pedal and this, and I could come up with those sounds that I really wanted to come up with. Now, I'm more of a country boy now, but these are my roots of my raisings. And this is my version of the Frankenstrat, and it works for me, and I'm so proud to have it. And I mean, we've even got different keys on it from different things. Parts have fell off. And yes, I could fix all of that now. I could retape it. I could do so much more to this and make it look like something that Eddie Van Halen would actually use. But why? Why mess with all that? Why not leave what I created as a child alone? You know, and so that's where I'm at on this. I'm going to leave it. Now, I haven't played this for a long time because it had a couple wires that loose. Back then, and even still today, I'm not the best solderer in the world, but I am better than I used to be. But the solder joints had broke from years back. The guitar was just basically unplayable. So now it's playable again. I've got one other modification I want to do to it that Eddie did on his Frankenstrat, and that's to put the eye hooks in for where the straps go, because I have lock straps for this, which I didn't get until later in life. But yeah, I've dropped this guitar many a times trying to swirl it around my head. Yeah, can you imagine this old man? Of course, back then I had long hair and thought I was really something. I'd swirl this thing around my head, and it flew off a couple times. That's what happened to the key on that end, the tuning key. A lot of the tape is strategically placed over big dents and dings and scratches and all that good stuff. anyways, so I'm going to leave it. This is a blast from my past. And, I mean, I actually put this kill switch in myself. Had never done it before. Didn't even do it right, but I did it. So all that being told, here it is, all its glory. I love it. I'm going to leave it the way that it is. Do I play that kind of music anymore? Not really. But it is fun to throw out a few little riffs here and there and remember the heyday that I had with this thing. So I'm going to get off of here. I just kind of wanted to show you guys what I was up to, show you a little bit of soldering. And once again, this is a general vlog video. Please give us a thumbs up. Please comment down below. I know this isn't my usual type of video, but I'm general. I'm in random, generally going to post anything and everything. So please, please, please subscribe down below and click that bell notification so you're notified when we post better videos than this. And I may have a cool throwback of a guitar that I had when I was young, but I'm still my own cameraman. I probably was back then too. And I've got to reach up here and get personal. Actually, I don't have to get up and get too personal with you. I can just kind of push. But I got to poke you in the ear right now to turn this video off. So we'll see you guys on the next video.